Okay guys, here is the final product. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So I always like to challenge myself to see what is the most creative video I can film for this channel. So I thought I would do the same this time and see what I will come up with. So as you guys know, I recently moved to a city and my apartment is really empty right now. So there's really nothing besides the basic furniture pieces. So I thought that this will be my chance to try and decorate the apartment the way I like it. I was shopping online for some home decors and I randomly came across these. So as you guys know, one, I like quality items, and number two, I don't like to spend too much money getting them. So I thought that this would be a perfect chance for me to try and test my creative skills and see if I can recreate something like this. So after doing some research online, I found that these are called macrame, and this is a form of textile that's created by knotting and usually it's done by hand. So because I'm really into DIY and hands-on projects, I figured that this would be the chance for me to try and make a macrame chandelier. So I have not done anything like this, and after doing some search on YouTube, I found this one macrame tutorial of how they make this two-layer chandelier. And because I am a complete beginner, I will have to first learn all the knots, and then number two, try and combine all the things I've learned into making this chandelier. And I feel like the ones I saw online are a little bit bigger than the one from this tutorial. So what I will do is that I will make this chandelier a little bit bigger just to match up with the sizes from the online stores. So if you guys are curious to see whether or not I can learn and make this massive chandelier, then stay tuned and hopefully I will do a final reveal at the end. So I'm really excited, but also I'm super nervous because I honestly don't know how this will turn out. So stay tuned! Okay guys, so after looking for an hour, I finally have all three items. So I found the cord and the two rings that I will be using. Because I feel like the chandelier in the tutorial is kind of small, so I'm going to increase it by half the size. So I know that the chandelier is divided into four total sections. I'm going to do six instead of four, so I can make it a little bit bigger. So the total for all three turns out to be $34, which is really not bad. Hey guys, I just got my first item. So this is the macrame cord. So before I start making the chandelier, I'm thinking about practicing making knots because I've never done it before and I don't even really know how to make some of the very basic knots. So I've taken out some of the cords. So the first one I'm going to do is a square knot. Oh, also because I don't have anything else, I'm going to practice making the knots on this just for now.
And fold it in half. Then take the folded end of your cord, loop it around the back side of the dowel, and then pull the tails through.
These are the square knots. It took me a couple of tries to get them, but I think once I got them down, it's actually not that hard. So the next one in the tutorial is the berry knot. Alright guys, I think I just made a berry knot. It's a little bit messy, but what do you guys think? I don't know what it looks like. It doesn't really look like a berry to me, but I guess it's still really pretty. So now with this done, I think my next one is to learn how to make the hitch knots. So I think those are the really thick ones. Thank you. bandage knots. I think that's what they're called. So yeah, what do you guys think? So I guess these are the three main knots that the chandelier has. I'm not sure what else it has, but if it does, I guess I'll just learn it along the way. So I got the macrame ropes today, and I'm supposed to be getting the smaller ring today as well. So I'm going to wait and see if I do get that. I will see you guys in the next clip. So we have this small hoop, and we also have the macrame cords. So with this, I can go ahead and get started, but I'm still waiting for the 19-inch hoop. So this will be my first time making a macrame anything, and you guys will be able to see me try this out for the first time. So we'll see how this goes. I'm honestly really nervous, and I think I set the bar really high for my first project. Hey guys, so this is my progress so far. So I found it really difficult to try and braid this on the table. So that's why I came up with this idea to hang it on top of this lamp. So I feel like by hanging this up, it makes it a little bit easier to braid just because I can see everything. I feel like this project is really time consuming. And today I spent 4 hours just making this diamond pattern right here. And I did this for all sides, so there are 6 sides total. And yeah, so it took a long time, but I think it turned out pretty good. I am so excited to say that the first half is finally done. So this took me over a week. So yeah, even this top part was a massive project. And I felt like the braiding wasn't really difficult, but it was just mainly trying to be persistent. And because this is really time consuming, I think I just kind of found it hard to fit this into my schedule this week. Like there were times where I felt like I was just too tired to braid, but I tried my best with this and I'm so glad that the first half is finally complete. Also, this was so much that my first roll actually ran out, so I had to order a second roll. I was honestly kind of surprised by how well this turned out because I thought it was just gonna fall apart or something's gonna go wrong, but it didn't. So now wish me luck on the second part. Hey guys, so I got a notification today and the ring for part 2 has finally arrived. I was waiting for over 2 weeks and it's finally here, so I am really excited. This is the ring for the second part, and this will go below all the things that I've already made. And this is huge, like look at this compared to the size of my head. This is insanely big, so I'm not sure how long it will take for me to finish this, but yeah, we'll see. So now with the second ring finally here, I will go ahead and start on the expansion portion. Without further ado, let's move on to the next part. Hey guys, so today was the second day working on the expansion parts, and today was really tiring, and by the end of the day I was just feeling really exhausted. I didn't really want to work on the chandelier because I honestly just wanted to rest. Even though I felt really tired, I still kept on going and I was able to get a little bit done. So definitely not as much as I wanted to, but I think it's better than nothing, right? So yeah, I think I will go ahead and call it night and I will get back to it tomorrow. Good morning, guys. So today is Sunday. I just took a shower and now I'm going to get back to making the chandelier. So I'm actually really behind on schedule because I was hoping to finish by last night. So I was on the last part of making the chandelier, so I'm almost done. But that last part is just taking me so long and I don't even know what to do. And I was also hoping to post the video by today because I usually upload my videos on Sundays. But I don't think that's going to happen, so I might have to push it back till next Sunday. So I'm really sorry, you guys, if you guys are waiting for the video to come out. I am doing as much as I can, and hopefully it will be out by next Sunday. So this is the chandelier so far, and I think it looks really good. And this is honestly so big. Like, this is the chandelier compared to like my hand. So I am on the last part of making the chandelier, and I was trying to do these tassels. So for this one, I have 6 different sections, and last night it took me around 3 hours just to do 2 of these. And what I had to do was that I had to take cords like this and I would comb it out. So if you can see, like at the end of these cords, the strands kind of separate. So I had to comb out all the cords so that it becomes like this. So my goal today would be to finish the other 4 tassels so I can have a full week of editing and get the video out by next Sunday. Oh yeah, also with combing these out, since these were really difficult to comb, I was actually using this pet comber because it's metal. I washed it really thoroughly with soap, so there's no pet hair or anything on this, so it's absolutely clean. So it means I just kept on doing this for around 3 hours last night, so I will be doing the same thing today. Okay guys, so after 20 days and over 50 hours of braiding, here is the final product. Alright guys, so this concludes the video for today, and thank you all so much for watching. And I'm so sorry for the delay with this video. I honestly didn't know how long this was gonna take for me to finish. So if you guys don't see me posting, just know that I am always working on something for YouTube, and I'm trying to make sure that the quality of the videos are good. And if you have suggestions for future videos, please make sure to comment down below. And if you enjoy these creative projects, please feel free to subscribe to my channel. I like to explore all kinds of creative fields, from fashion to arts and crafts and to dancing, and I would love to have you on my journey. So thank you all so much again, and I will see you guys next time.